Hey there, we meet again with another tarot deck review, and I got the magical forest tarot, which was in my A list for quite a while, and I got this from another YouTuber. It later occurred, so to spirit, thank you. I really really am loving this deck, and this is the box it came in. The cards are in really really great shape. I'm not sure if you ever used them or not, and I swapped them for the Radiant Tarot in Radiant Rider White in tin. And this is, I also already trimmed them and etched them dark green. And look at that. Ooh, magical. Magical forest indeed. So why I wanted this deck, because I sometimes work with children and this deck, and sometimes some people are feeling so gloomy that the ordinary tarot deck will just spook them and they can't think straight. And when I whip out this deck, this the whole thing becomes lighter and easier maybe to work with. I usually let the client pick the cards, and I have really missed this type of deck as an addition to my selection for the client. Okay. Now, I little bit peeked to the little white book, and I want to read some things from there as we go. And this is the Rider White clone. No, clone is when the images are the same but colors or something is different. This is the Rider-Waite system, but it follows it like exactly, only with characters are a little bit different. And this is the fool. I love the little toy, the pull toy doggy he has there, so cute. The Magician, the High Priestess, Empress, Emperor. I wanted to say the owl, the hierophant. The little mouse is here, looking up to him or her. So cute. Lovers. Look at that. The chariot. Hedgehog. Strength card. This card was the first card from this deck. I saw someone shared it on Instagram, and I was like, sold! I wanted to see the other cards. And then when I saw it, I was like, I must have it. But they don't sell this deck around here, nowhere. Never had, never will, probably. So I was so happy to get this. The Hermit, the Polar Bear. Every time, bear with me. Okay, I love puns, and I intend my puns usually. The wheel, justice, the eye of the justice. This is a really great pick of an animal to show the justice card. The hangman, a albino, bat with a book. Beautiful card. Death. How pretty is this? This is so beautiful. The fear in those eyes is like paralyzed. Many people are afraid of. How did some of the cards go backwards? I know exactly when I edge them, trim them, I put them in right position. So the temperance and the sun is again peaking. So the devil, isn't this just the sheeps are sheathed or how it's called, shed there. The tower, the piglet and the doggy are falling from there in the rain, in the rubble. Although I don't like the tower cards because of the falling people and my fear of heights and but this is not frightening, but this is, I want to save them, I want to catch them. The star, the five senses shown here, and the bird, all the details of the rider white are visible here if you can see, if you look closely. The guardians instead of the howling dog and wolf here, and the gates here. The moon even looks cute. The sun. Judgment. And the world. Ace of Swords. The paws are so cute. Two of Swords. Now, the swords show cats. And I am going to read from here. The family of cats is the most intellectually lively one. They are fickle and are essentially occupied with nourishing their minds, often seeking to understand the rules of nature. They teach what they have learned to all the inhabitants of the forest. When they are not jumping among the branches of the trees, they love long conversations. They vary in color, are often striped, and their symbol is the sword they use in special combat rituals because it can scratch like their sharpened claws. Humans call them swords and associate them with minds, intellect, reason, thoughts, and philosophy. Three of Swords. Four of Swords. Five of Swords. All the defeated ones there. Six of Swords. Seven of Swords. Eight of Swords. Are they all wearing boots? I didn't note this before. Yes, they are all wearing boots. Nine of Swords. And Ten of Swords. I love how this card is shown. It's like spooked out little kitten here, and the swords are not piercing the body, as you can see on some of the cards, that they are actually going in, but here you can just, it's hinted, or you can't just get spooked out. Ah, the Page of Swords, Knight of Swords, Queen of Swords on the high mountain top or a cliff, and King of Swords. Wands. The frog hand here, so cute. Now for the frogs, the little white book says, the family of frogs represent the most imaginative and creative creatures you can meet. They are responsible for discovering the mysteries of life and to sow and cultivate the plants of the enchanted forest, together with the bunnies. And the bunnies are the chalices then, emotions. Together with the bunnies, they preside over engagements and weddings, because it is said that they particularly enjoy the joys of sex. Fire signs. And frog and bunnies. Oh my god, this reference. Okay. They also love to invent and organize games for the entire community. They are green, and their symbol is a branch that they use sometimes for support and sometimes for play. Humans call them wands and associate them with their imagination, creativity, sexuality, and life energy. So, Two of Wands. Three of Wands. Four of Wands, a dance. Beautiful. Five of Wands. Look how this forms a almost a pentacle pattern. They are getting there. Whatever they are trying to build, they are almost getting there. Six of Wands. I initially thought it was another frog, but the tongue here tells me it's a lizard or the salamander, which is fire sign also, as the wands is, are. Seven of Wands. Eight of Wands. I love the vibrant colors also of this deck. Nine of Wands. The facial expression is not so happy here. So, very well drawn, very well made art. And Ten of Wands. Page of Wands. with the beret and a feather here. It's all in details. And the Knight of Wands, also not another frog, but the lizard. Because it's initially it didn't make sense why the frog is on riding a frog. It's not making sense. But as I looked at the tongues, I understood. Queen of Wands, the cat, and the sunflower. And King of Wands, the lizard. Like I said, the details of the Rider-Waite are all here. Cups. And again, the little paw. Okay, now for the bunnies. The family of bunnies represents the most sensitive and innocent creatures. They are responsible for providing joy and well-being to the community by nurturing friendships and affection. Sometimes they are a bit guileless. I'm gonna show you that word. I don't know how to. Guileless. I'm not sure how to pronounce that word. But they are always appreciated when they organize ritual toasts that are said to be very good for the heart. They are almost always white, and their symbol is a goblet that they bear as a sign of peace. Humans call them chalices, and they associate them with their sensitivity, emotions, passions, and affairs of the heart. This is beautiful. Lion. Caduceus. As I said, every detail from the Rider-Waite is here. The Three of Cups. Celebrating the crops. Four of Cups. Five of Cups. At least looks like he's seeing the standing cups. Six of Cups. Seven of Cups. I just wanted to see what this is representing. The riches, the property, the fame, the magic, the rebirth, the how it's called, spiritual ascension and seeing things without actually seeing. Oh, this is instead of the usual woman's head there. I always had problem with that. Okay. Eight of Cups. You can see he's already crossed the river here. No turning back. Went already. Decided to go. And the moon is the waning moon. Sign of ending things. Nine of Cups. And Ten of Cups. Look at that. Just pretty. Page of Cups. Knight of Cups. Queen of Cups. And the King of Cups. Ace of Pentacles. And the Foxes. The family of foxes is the most astute and pragmatic of all the animals. The foxes are responsible for building solid refuges and collecting and distributing resources so that all may be guaranteed food and shelter. They love everything that is practical and concrete and have a very practical nature. They are reddish in color and their symbol is a yellow golden disc that is known throughout the forest as Dew Tender. Humans call them pentacles and associate them with material goods, business, money, career, and success. I love how the story has been invented. Three of Pentacles. Four of Pentacles. Five of Pentacles. Six of Pentacles. Seven of Pentacles. Eight of Pentacles. Nine of Pentacles. And 10 of Pentacles, and a little squirrel here. Actually, I get something else from this picture than the usual happy family together. This looks like she's leaving. Or not talking, the silent treatment maybe. Interesting, let's see what they say about this. A new beginning. No, I'm sorry. I read the frogs. Foxes, success and wealth. Well, I tend to use the images as what I see from them. So I saw that. Okay. Page of Pentacles. Knight of Pentacles. I love that. This is just awesome. Queen of Pentacles. And King of Pentacles. So this was the magical forest. Oh, look at what I done. But look at what you did. Luckily I didn't smear the cards in it. Well, that happened one time too many. I'm gonna clean up the mess later. So my conclusion, don't look at that. If you have some kind of the cleaning issue, then you should look away. Just listen. Listen to my voice. I'm sorry. I'm feeling kind of quirky today. So, the deck, definite keeper. This is the deck I have wanted for so quite a time. And I love it, and I'm so happy that I got it, and look at how great he sits in the hand when I... And the stripes here are the... See? Not that I edged them badly, but I didn't want to use the real dark green, so the pattern is coming through, but this looks really awesome like that. I love it. I love how it just, you have to have, I don't know, this deck immediately pulled out the child in me, as you can already maybe noticed, so. But I love them trimmed. The pictures are just popping out and it runs very well, smoothly. And yes, I'm going to now ask the questions. And I have a strong feeling they will help me, the inner child work and childhood traumas waking or digging out the childhood traumas and healing them. I think this deck will help me with this work also. So, because so many problems and things are from our childhood, so if we can just fix them, they will stay and pop out whenever we can't actually control it, and it is good to heal from the old wounds that we can't actually change anymore. Okay, this is the deck. Thank you to Spirit for this wonderful opportunity for me to get them. And I love them, and I thank you, and I thank everyone for watching this video and listening, and have a great day. Goodbye.